Let's find each letter. The B, the A, the K, the E, and the R. The outline for each letter would look like this. So basically, that means that everything else than this is actually just extra add-ons. So what makes this piece so good? It's super coherent in style. It's a bit aggressive with these rough edges like this one, and here, and all these extra add-ons. The only true curved elements found in this piece is actually over here, and the E, and over here as well. The fundament of this piece actually lies in the logs that looks like this. If we take this log, we can make it fit almost everywhere. It's the same as this one. It's the same as the bottom of the K here. It's the same as the bottom of the B here. It's the same as the top of the B as well. If we look at the symmetry part of the piece, we have a line going here and here as well. This movement here and this movement here as well. Also, it's going up in the top here, down in the bottom. So the overall shape of this piece is actually symmetrical. Just like this. There's an oval movement in this piece that leads the eyes towards the middle. We see this in the movement here, 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 here. The 3D is also following a vanishing point that lies down here, which also underlies this statement. This three-dimensional vibe is also underlined by these white highlights that are floating above the piece, including the car shadow we see in the 3D as well. Here and here, here, here. All over. The color scheme of this piece is nuances of brown made on a black background with a touch of these yellow fuzzing lines to break this. Yellow and black are also considered the most attention-grabbing colors to put up next to each other. The color scheme would look like this. Take a screenshot or save the video if you want to use it for your next piece. Who's next?